we're talking to Harry Tambuatko, and the topic is democracy on sale. We're saying democracy on sale because, well, it's a bidding war every election time. No? And anyway, so I had the hanging question. If running a campaign has gone up, can we also say that corruption has gone up?
The illusion that Daang Matuwid has been saying, kung walang walang korap, walang mahirap. In fact, in reality, and the truth, it's very verifiable and it's obvious. Without a doubt, everything has gone up.
Okay.
Nagmamahala na talaga lahat. Okay. Tsaka hindi ka pwede tumakbo, Eric, period, pag wala kang pera. Now, whether corruption has gone up, obviously, because bakit ka gagastos? Magkano kaya ang dosi ng senador? National yan, hindi gaya ng Congress. Okay. Magkano ginastos kaya nila yan? Magkano minimum? 80, 100 million? How are they supposed to make that back in 6 years?
Sa media pa lang, patay na.
Patay na, oh, huli na.
Oo.
Hindi lang patay na, huli na. Yung presidente, except for Duterte, who obviously did not have any ads,
yeah.
Minimal eh.
Yeah, oh.
Pero last year, again, Mar Rojas, what's her name? The American woman. The American,
yeah, Grace, oh,
and Binay Iben. I mean, yung gastusin nila, alam mo, in 6 years, it's not possible to get it back because tignan mo lang yung sweldo eh.
Would it be also valid to say that, oh, but we can get this from contributors?
You can't keep getting money from contributors.
At those levels?
Oh, hindi pwede.
Masyado malaki.
Yeah, masyado. Hindi. Tsaka for what purpose? Ano yan? Para huwag mo tirahin industry ko, ha?
Okay.
Huwag mo tirahin, I'm in casino, I'm in the gaming. Huwag mo papasukan yan. Telecom sa ko, huwag mo bibirahin yan. Just look the other way. Marami naman. Ayusin mo pagkain, huwag mo titirahin industry ako. Ganun naman labanan dyan.
So what happens is, it's a combination of corruption and contribution.
Corruption is influence peddling. You pay for that. You either pay during the campaign or you pay during the period of the reign of the ruler.
How about people who make use of government money in order to get free advertisement?
Hindi, ang tawag dyan, straight corruption yun eh.
Corruption pa din.
No, straight corruption into the pocket. Di ba? Diretsuhan.
Kasi ginagamit yung pera ng taong bayan para
correct.
Sa free ads nila.
Correct.
Yun ang pambayan.
Oo, oh, free ads. Hindi. Look at si Tesda man.
Oh.
How many streamers were out there nakalagay Tesda? Sino nagbayad kaya nun?
Okay.
Yung kay, what's her name? Antiveros.
Yes.
The same thing. Di ba?
Okay.
How much did government put out? Gee, the whole LP campaign, the Liberal Party, used all the funds of the government, from the trucks, of the military, to everything.
Can Risa Ontivero say, oh, but these are all contributions?
Whether it's contribution or not, you do not get anything for free. Come on, there's no such thing as a free
lunch. And not at that huge.
Oh, masyado malaki.
Ganun kalaki, no?
May purpose yan, lahat yan. Ikaw ba, will accept money, bibigyan kita ngayon ng 1 million. Tapos sabihin mo sa akin, na contribution ko yan para manalo ka. Are you, accept mo ba 1 million?
I mean, okay.
Ano ako, bobo?
Here's another thing. May sose para sa mga kandidato. Meron ba tayong batas para dun sa mga nagko-contribute?
Yes, you have 30 days to do it right after the election.
Yung sose, yung mga kandidato?
Oo.
Pero yung mga nag-contribute?
No, all you have to do is don't issue a receipt. Parang VAT yan eh.
Wala ba tayong batas? Hindi ba dapat may batas?
May batas yun, pero how do you recognize it? How do you record it? When you buy or sell something from somebody and there is no official receipt, there is no recording, there is no tax payment, and there is no breaking the law because there is no receipt. Di ba? Bibigay ko sa'yo, 10 million. Walang
record?
Oo. Tsaka minsan, hindi check eh. Cash.
So cash, hindi makikita?
Hindi makikita.
So
of course.
That also bridge?
Because the big companies don't want to put money out because kung magkaipitan, nagkahulihan, selective justice ka, tinignan ka ng maigi ng NBI or whatnot, hinabol ka, wala, hindi lalabas yan, no expense yan, no expense paid.
That is another bridge to corruption.
It's the act itself is corrupt, by itself. Here, when you don't give a VAT, hindi ka nag official receipt, in reality, you're hiding your taxes.
Question, namili ba ng mga boto yung mga kalaban mo sa...
Without a doubt.
Now, question, bawal yun?
Of course!
Now, morally speaking, masama ba yun sa Diyos pag mamili ka ng boto?
Of course, it's morally incorrect. Okay. Eh, hindi naman maka-Diyos mga yan eh.
So, bawal mamili ng boto sa harap ng mata ng Diyos?
Oo, of course.
Bawal din sa batas?
Of course. Pero kung magpo-politiko ka at ang interest mo personal, wala kang morality.
Ngayon, etong tanong, kung isang boto ang binili mo, masama na yun sa Diyos.
Of course, it's one and the same.
Eh paano kung isang milyon ang binili mo?
Mas masama sa Diyos 1 million times. So, di ba? Ay, wala naman may iba dun eh.
So, is that what is happening?
I think it has
binibili
been...
na lahat ng mga boto ng...
Yes, it's called SOP. Standard Operating Procedure.
Now, the next question is, pag ikaw ang butante, tumanggap ka naman ng pera at nagpabili ka sa boto mo,
it's just as bad.
Bawal sa batas, bawal din sa Diyos.
Oh, it's just as bad. Pero...
nagkasala ka sa Diyos din.
Ang problema kasi ng mga iba naman sa probinsya, mga talagang kapit-patalim.
Oh.
One, may galit na yan sa gobyerno kasi wala nangyayari sa kanya.
Okay.
He will accept the money, pocket it, and because he's still Filipino, because you corrupted me, the least I can do is vote you.
May konsensya?
Oh, may konsensya yung...
may konsensya pa rin?
The immoral act is moralized by following through with the corruption that was paid for. I know it's ridiculous, but this
is the
case.
That sense, may konsyensya pa?
Yes. Ang konsyensya, kasi binayaran mo siya when the act is already wrong. Now, is it education? Is it the morality of the people? Or is it because the requirement for money because of the poverty that they are being made to experience?
Now, here is now the question. Okay, nakatanggap, ibinoto ka.
Mm.
Alin ang iboboto niya? Yung taong nakatulong sa kanya ng 3 taon? The person or the incumbent who has helped him for 3 years or the person who has last given him the
second,
money?
The latter. Because
yung nagbigay ng pera?
Yes. Because the person who has helped him the last 3 years, ang feeling nila, eh, trabaho mo naman yan eh. Gobyerno yan eh. That's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to serve. So you serve me.
So wala na konsyensya yung nakatulong ka ng 3 taon sa kanya?
Wala. Pag immediate money, ang morality allows for a new kind of loyalty that follows through. This is the way I see it. This is the way I think it's
so been last happening. In, first out?
Oh, just because magaling ka, it doesn't mean papasok ka uli. It doesn't follow. Pag hindi ka naglabas ng pera, walang mangyayari sa'yo.
Because there are so many candidates now, there are so many political parties, it therefore follows also na tama, tumaas yung gastusin.
Mm. One follows the other. It corrupts the other.
Because the parties are also spending. All the political parties are basically spending.
Yes. And where is that money coming from? Contributions. Contributions from where? Big business. Big business requires influence peddling so that their industry does not get hurt.
Harry, do you believe that there are party lists that are also buying votes now?
Of course.
You agree with that?
Well, to begin with, because I don't like the party list system, but yeah. I know they are.
They're also buying now,
yes.
Unlike before.
Yes, they're buying.
So they're now competing with the conventional parties.
Correct, correct. Well, the whole system is wrong.
Okay.
I believe, but that's another topic. But yes, the answer is a resounding yes.
So do we have an election or a bidding war?
We have a bidding war.
So,
tsaka kung sino mas malaking pera,
okay.
Yun ang mananalo. Without a doubt. Without a doubt.
So it's all about kung sino unang huli makabigay ng pera, yun na yun.
Of course. Ganun talaga yun. Alam mo, parang media yan eh. Sa media, miskin napaka-popular mo, mawala ka lang isang taon, nakalimutan ka na ng taong bayan. Alam mo, you're only as good as your last showing.
Yes.
Ganun din ang salesman.
Okay.
Yung magaling na salesman na magaling magbenta,
uh-oh,
is only as good as his last sale.
Okay.
It's always the case. That's how the professions work. When you're out of the picture, you're gone. It is harder sometimes to climb back.
Can money be used for a very good candidate, good material for senator, president, or congressman, a good material with good plans, money used to defeat his candidacy?
Yes.
Special operations?
Can. And you, well, this is exactly what happened to Binay. This is exactly what we've seen. We've seen the Liberal Party money and Noy Noy's group and his Yellow Army and ruin Binay without actually going, you know, may immunity yan, di ba?
Okay, okay.
Ang ginawa, tinira pamilya niya, sinira siya. They really haven't proven anything and Binay is correct. Vice President Binay is correct. Hindi naman korto eh. Hindi naman ako hinusgahan pa eh.
Yes.
Ginawa nito, binastos ako ng 3 senador. They put him down, they ruined his chances. But whether he's guilty or not, if I'm not mistaken, it has to go to court. Yes. And if I'm not mistaken, he has immunity until July 1.
Yes.
Pero inunahan siya. And of course, Department of Justice and everybody else looked the other way. Now, after July 1, i-file nila yung kaso, kung pumasok yan, ngayon labanin niya, until you're convicted, correct me if I'm wrong, hindi.
Yes.
Alam mo, even if it's glaring, the act of corruption or misdeed is glaring until you are proven, hindi ka pa criminal, di ba?
Yes.
Until nahusgahan ka na.
Oh.
Until then, the law says you're still innocent.
Yes.
Now, the problem with media is media will already tell you, corrupt ka. Now, for you to buy back the time, you have to pay now on TV, to go on TV.
Goodwill.
Anjaryo. Anong style ng anjaryo? Lalagay ka sa front page. Tapos bigla magkaka-eratum. Yung eratum na sa page 3, page 4, page 5. Maliit lang ang sulat doon, eratum. We have an error, we only meant this. Mali ang sinabi namin. Pero yung tinira ka front page.
Sa newspaper, magkano ang ano?
Ang eratum is free.
Yung columnar space. Advertisement kayo? 70,000?
Sure. Half a page? Alam ko, let's say half a page, no? Full page is about 400.
Ngayon,
ha? It's a weekend.
Basta sa campaign?
On the average, you're talking about 200 for a half page. Pag color, mga 30%, 40% more. So, you're talking 250. Average, 250.
Okay.
So, dumukuning, 500, 250, and divided that by 2, you get 1/4 page.
Sa radio, magkano kailangan may gastos sa national?
Well, there is no real national. Ilan lang naman ang national radio stations. There's only 3, I think, or 4, di ba? Malaki na dyan kasi per spot, you're talking 150. Malaki.
Okay.
But it's still affordable, all considering. But you see, in radio, it is not your 30-second, ano. Don't forget, ang radio, hindi yung babayaran mo yung 30-second spot na gagawin mong parang political ad.
Yes.
Ang binabayaran mo, yung announcer, yung endorsement.
Commentator.
Commentator. Bigyan mo 100,000 yan. Pare, ako pag-usapan nyo.
Okay.
Diba? Tapos lalabas ang konting ad. Tapos kayong pag-usapan. He will endorse you, blindsiding you, but making you look good all the time.
Okay.
Diba? And two, it goes both ways.
Or he can attack the other person.
Kasi ang tawag dyan, PR.
Yes.
And this is really fair game. Strategic yan. That's what you mean by paying for radio. Ganon din naman ang print both ways. Just because the newspaper ad, you think babasahin, mas binabasa yung column, saying the written word is stronger than the whole ad.
Mm.
So you pay the printer, miski pa paano, the columnist.
We're surgically examining how it is to have a campaign so that our public has an idea, no? On top of that, meron ka pang sample ballots.
Iba pa yun.
Yes. So gagastos ka, kung congressional, citywide, national, iba pa yun. Mm. Number two, watchers on election day. That's another one. If you'll have your own, or if you don't want to have your own, you have to give to the mayor.
Correct. Kung hindi ka makakapasok.
Para bantayan ka doon.
Isa pa yun.
Iba pa yung dadalhin ka ng mayor, iba pa yung watchers na magbabantay para sa boto mo. So how many mayors, how many all over the Philippines,
correct,
how many governors, bibigyan mo pa rin.
Correct.
Tama.
Hindi ka makakapasok sa mga municipalities at cities pag hindi ka approve ng governor. Diba? Aharangin ka. You gotta remember, national road yan bago makapasok sa mga cities.
Okay, we're going to pause for a few reminders and then we'll still go through anong mga expenses you'll go through until we finally get an idea na how difficult or how easy is it to run for public office when we return.
Kung marami kang...